Hello everyone. Welcome to the tutorial of JMeter, a performance testing. In last video, we have seen installation of Java and JMeter on your system. In this video, we are going to learn overview of JMeter. Means here we will see a quick introduction of all the components of JMeter. So now I am opening JMeter, which we have installed on the system, that is Apache JMeter version 5.4.1. In that, as I told you in the last video, that we have to open batch file. We need not required to install JMeter on PC. We just have to extract and open batch file of the JMeter. So now see, you can see here, this is a Windows batch file for a JMeter. I'm just double click on it. Now here you can see my JMeter window is opening. This is the home screen which I have shown you in the last video. This is the home screen of the Apache JMeter. So I just want to give you the overview today. You can see here in this screen, on the left side of the screen, there is test plan. Okay, so here, whatever functions you will be doing on the left part of the screen, that will automatically get opened in the right part. Means it is called as a writing part of a Apache JMeter. Okay. Now, here there are some options like file, edit, search, run options, and tools and help. So these options we will see one by one in detail, but today we will just overlook what is Apache JMeter. So first of all, I just want to tell you the save option. So here, once you will click on file, there is save option. So click on it whenever you want to save your tests. So here you can choose the location of saving your test plan. So if I want to give or rename my test plan as a test one, so I have renamed it as a test one, and all these files of the JMeter will get saved by using the extension as .jmx. You can see here. Okay, the file type is JMeter, means .jmx. Now save it. So this is the way how you are going to save your test plan. If I want to open my test plan, so in file, you can get this option as a open. So here again in the bin folder, the test plan which I have created is test one. Now I'm opening that test plan. Okay, so click on test1.jmx and open it. So in this way, how you are going to save and open the test plan in the JMeter. Okay, so now I just want to tell you about what is test plan. Okay, so test plan is nothing but a container for the test cases. Means whatever test cases you are creating will be created under this test plan. Then I'm right clicking on this test plan. So I will get all these options like add, paste, open, merge, and etc. etc. So first of all, we will see what is this add option in this lecture. So in the add option, you can see there are sub options like threads, config elements, listener, timer, preprocessors, postprocessors, assertions, tag fragment, and non-test elements. So here, what is mean by thread? We will go one by one. So what is mean by thread? Thread are nothing but the instance which are required to create a virtual users. Means here, whenever you are creating a new thread, suppose now I'm creating new thread as a named as thread group. So now you can see it is a tree like structure. Under the test plan, I have created one new thread. So I can rename this thread whatever I want to give the name. But if I want to keep the same name, I will write as it is thread group. Okay. Then this trade group is creating hundreds of the user which are virtual in the nature. Means the main function of JMeter is to create a virtual users, or you can say a virtual threads for doing the test cases. Okay, now this is the one thread, or we can say a thread group I have created. In this way, I can create a multiple thread groups. You can see here, I can create a multiple thread groups under my test plan. Now, in this thread group, there are some options. Again, the similar options are there, which are present in test plan. In the test plan, you can see here, the same options are there. So we will see the options under the thread group. Okay. So here, there are some of the options under thread groups. In that, first option is sampler. Now, what is the function of this sampler? Sampler is used to create a request or to generate a request in a test plan. You can see here, under the samplers, you will get number of requests like flow control action, HTTP request, debug samplers, and bold requests, FTP requests, etc. Java request. So all these requests are used for opening the, for example, for opening a website. Suppose I want to open a particular website. Which request I will take? I will take this HTTP request for opening the website. So we will take just HTTP one request as a HTTP request in our test plan. In this way, we are going to add the sampler in the test plan. Now, what is second option? Second option is nothing but the, you can see here, it is a logic controller. Now, all of you know the meaning of controller or loops in every programming language. You can see here, under logic controller, there are sub-controllers like if controller, loop controller, while controller, random controller, simple controller. So what are the functions? Switch controller, you can see. What are the functions of this controller in any programming language is to control a particular problem statements. So here, in case of JMeter, these controllers are used for controlling the requests. For example, or you can say controlling the traffic on a particular page. For example, suppose I'm opening the Facebook site, and on that site, I want that after, if I'm logging into the system, suppose user is, any particular user is successfully logged in into the system, that particular login page will be reflected towards the home page. Means after login page, the home page will be displayed automatically. So here we can use the if else controller. If user is logged in successfully, then home page will get reflected automatically. Okay. If user is not logging successfully, if he is giving wrong password, then it must give an error message. So that is the main function of these controllers over here. This is just one example I have given to you. So I'm just taking one controller for sample purpose. So I have taken here if controller. You can see here it has been added under the thread group. First of all, we have created HTTP request and then if controller got added. Okay. Now, what is the third element? You can see under the thread group, is third element is pre-processors and the post-processors. Now, what are these pre-processors and the post-processors are? Nothing but pre-processors are means the activity which you want to perform before performing any action, and post-processors are nothing but the activity which you have to perform after execution of a particular action, event or action, you can say. Okay, so for that purpose, we are creating these pre-processors and the post-processors. For example, before opening of the website, any website, what I have to do, I have to send a particular request, like open that particular website. So that is, that will come under this pre-processors. And post-processor means after completion of my task on that website, I will create a request from this post-processor. Now we will create just one pre-processor and one post-processor over here. Any one we will take. Similarly, post-processor, I have taken the pre-processor. Similarly, I am taking any one of the post-processor over here. Okay. Now, what is the next element? The next element is nothing but the assertions. Now, what do you mean by these assertions? The main function of this assertion is to create true or false request. For example, all of you might be knowing, I am writing the test cases, suppose, and some of the test cases are giving a positive result, means they are giving a true result, then that will come under the true. And some of the test cases are giving the false result, so that will be come under the false, means the test cases which will give the true result are called as past test cases, and the test cases which are giving the wrong result or error, then it will be a failed test cases. For example, again I am giving one example of Facebook, that is I am logged in into the Facebook website. So what is the function of this assertions? Whenever a user is entering the correct password, okay, then that will come under true, or we can say past test cases. And if user is putting a wrong password, then it is giving an error, or whenever, so all these will come under the past test cases. If user is giving the password rightly, still it is giving an error, then it will come under the failed test cases. So that is the main function of this assertion. So I'm just taking one assertion, that is HTML assertion, suppose in this particular test case, or we can say test group, sorry. So this is the next element, that is called as assertion. Okay, now what is the next element after that? Assertion is nothing but the timer. Okay, now the general meaning of timer is to check which user is doing what at a particular time. Okay, for example, again I am giving the website of Facebook, in which suppose at 12 o'clock there are thousand users are logged in. Okay, it is not like that all the users are sending the friend requests. Also, it is not like that some of the all the users are posting their on their wall. Okay, so every user might be doing different tasks. Okay, so some of the, suppose out of 1,000, two users are sending the friend requests to their friends. Out of 1,000 user, some of the users are keeping or posting the posts on their wall. So the timer is nothing but it is calculating that which user is doing what on my particular website. That is the main function of this timer. Suppose you can do this by logged in this Facebook website in a multiple tab on your PC. Okay, if you are logged in on a multiple time, it means that multiple users are suppose logged in. Okay, so from that you will come to know what is the meaning of timer. Out of that, in some of the tab you do a particular task, in some of the tabs you do the different tasks. Okay, so from that the timing of the users or the traffic at a particular element of the website will be calculated from the timer. Like this, for this particular time, 5 users were there on this particular element. So from that, the website, we can calculate the traffic of the website. Okay, so now I'm just taking one timer for this particular test group. Now, so these are some of the elements which we have added. Now, what are the next elements? Next element which I want to tell you is the listener. First, what is the listener here? Listener, as name is given as a listener, the main function of this JMeter is to listen the system and generate a report. So the main function of this listener is to generate reports in a user-friendly manner, or the user understandable format, you can say. For example, you can see here summary report, aggregate report, backend listeners. So all these graph results generate a summary result. So it will generate a result in a user friendly format or user understandable format. So that is the main function of this listener. Now we are just taking one graph result in this particular test group. Okay, so these are some of the elements we have added in our test plan. Now, what are the other elements other than this, which are present on this screen? Once all these elements are added, I need to save it. So here you can see there is one save option. So you can click on it, or from the file also you can save. Okay, and then here you can see this button is used for running your test plan. Whenever I'm clicking on this button, my test plan will get automatically executed. Okay. Here you can see search option is there. Search option, and here the clear option is there. What is the function of this clear option? Whenever you are running your test plan first time and you are generating some results over here, so that result will get saved in the cache. If again after some time I'm running the same test plan, I don't want my previous results to be displayed on my screen. So at that time you have to click on this clear button. So by using this clear button, you can delete or remove the previous results which you will get from the JMeter. Okay, so in short, I just want to take a quick overview of these particular elements today. Later on in the next tutorials, we will see all these different elements one by one in deep. So what we have done today is we have created a new test group by right clicking on the test plan. What is a test plan? Test plan is nothing but the container for a test cases or the scripts which we are creating. Okay, here you can create a multiple test groups. What is the function of this thread group? What is the function of this thread group? Thread groups are used for creating a virtual users in your system. So here we have created one thread group. Below that, we have added some elements which are required for us. Like I have added the sampler. The function of this sampler is to generate a request for any website. Logic controller are used to control the hitting of the website from one page to another page. Preprocessors are nothing but the activities which you have to do before occurring of a particular events. Post-processors are nothing but the activities which you have to do after occurring of a particular event. What are the assertions? Assertions are nothing but the test cases results that may be a pass or fail. I have given this with the example. What are timers? Timers are nothing but the calculating the time or the traffic on the site, means at which time which user is doing what. From this timer you will get that. Okay, what is the next we have added? Next element that we have added as a listener. The listeners are nothing but the things which are generating the results, and those results are generated in the graphical format, or you can say the results are in the human understandable format. Okay, so in this way today we have created a general test plan. So in the next tutorials we will see all these elements one by one. Then you will come to know what are the meaning of each controller. Okay, and in next lecture or next video we are going to learn about how to create a simple test plan. Meanwhile, thank you for watching this video.